Yo, Songbird Day 288. Here we go. Working on doors, making these doors single-use keys. Well, keys and doors and all that. I'm trying out this experiment with keys being, instead of being color-coded, keys are single-use. What's up, Scotch Pizza? What's up, Jules? Boogie, what's up? Howdy, y'all. Oh, hey, guys, D. Pedro, what's up? Yeah. Congratulations to Boogie and Pedro. New mods. Aslier, what's up, man? So, yeah, what's this? Pedro, that's so awesome. I like the two dudes in the front, too. They got their own look as well, but the four BC Warriors, so hilarious. Who are these guys? They're so great. Sound today. Yes, we have sound today. Things are working. Yay. So what am I working on now? Well, it looks like I crashed the game. Hold on a sec. Cool, sounds good, nice. Yeah, so what I'm working on today is the doors. These are now single use. And the game tracks what doors you've opened, so you have to, once you use a key, it has to remember what door has been opened. And also making them way clearer. So right now, you can really tell that door is locked up there. Same thing with these doors over here. And also if you get, So there you can now see that doors are much clearer when they are opened. So regular doors now have this glow. When they're unlocked, it's very, very clear that this whole room is open. All these doors are open, I mean. Yeah. So, there's one more thing I gotta work on. Alex Pita! Jules, yes, I had struggles with OBS. Many struggles to get my voice in sync, and no matter what I tried, all the options, I literally tried every option in OBS, cross-platform for Mac, and it wouldn't work. So, Game Show works quite well. I'm happy to pay for it just to get better quality videos, because these things have my voice in sync, and also have audio working where you can record my actual system audio rather than recording through my speakers. OBS requires some, you know, installing an extension or whatever to get that to work, and I just never could get it working. So that's why I use Game Show. Yes, Boogie. Maybe 9.5. What's up, Alex Pita? Happy New Year to you too, man. Happy 2016. Okay, so there's this one room where, actually, let's just go there. The boss room. The boss room has one little issue. So the way it works now is when a door has been opened, it has to save that the door has been opened. And there's actually two doors each time. There's one door. And then the other room's door back in the other direction. So this stores the doors which have been opened. And then stores keys as well that have been used. Yes, we got a lot of green swords today. Everybody's modded. So the problem is in the boss door, or in the boss room, it treats it like a regular locked door. So I just need to work on that. Right here. So that door is locked now. It shouldn't be. Because the boss has been defeated. Mod Wars. So we learned yesterday that mods can't ban each other. Okay, so this door right here needs to not be locked. Ooh, nice one. That's in door system. Here's where it locks the doors. Okay. You're right. Okay, so I made this one change to... Here we go. Dungeons are now set up for single-use keys. Oh, maybe it's not here. Maybe it's here. Single-use keys. Door system. Use key. There it is. Here's the old code. This works particularly well for... hey guys! For switches. So this is single use keys. Multi-use keys slash switches. So this is if door condition is greater than zero and door condition is less than K num keys. Oh wait, no, that's the other one. Oh, yeah. That's the other one up here. That's a single use key. This. This is less than knum key types plus knum switch types. And we gotta grab the gear. I'm lazy, so I'm just copying it from the old. There we go. There, so now we got both kinds of keys, which can unlock doors. Right, single use is greater than zero, less than knum key types. That's wrong. Greater than zero would be one through four, or that. And this is going to be greater than num key types. This is going to be greater, less than or equal to eight. There. You're finally watching Star Wars? Nice. She watched those ones. Yeah, who wouldn't watch four through six? What was her problem with four through six? Didn't unlock that door. Okay, let's see what's going on. Yeah, so after I fix this little bug, I'm gonna start drawing a cool animation for doors that lock, so that when they lock and when they unlock, they have a sweet animation. All right. So it should be the very first door. This is a door on the bottom. Locked is false to start with. Good. Direction east. Oh, that's the wrong door. What? It didn't even go through that one. Oh. Probably because that. I I've already done the thing with the teleport cube. Oh, where the teleport cube? Yes, I did. And oh, thanks for your suggestion about it being in the bike. But I did go with a different thing because of the story. So I've at the end of the first dungeon, you're going to find the teleport cube. And it's because of the story. And you'll see why later when once I finally get the story in. But I am going to put... I loved your idea so much that I'm going to definitely put some secret item or something in the bikes. Maybe something that you collect. Yeah, how is everybody's games going? This door is the east door. East door. South door. Here we go. Not doors empty. Door.locked. It's not equal to locked. Locked is false. Locked is true. That should get in there. Oh, okay. It did work. Nice. Yeah, Scottish Pizza's working on an album too right now. Yes. Yeah. That's going to be an alpha update. So, yep. I got a few more days this weekend to get some more new things done. And then Monday, I'm starting on refining the game, making sure everything still works, playing it, all that. And Tuesday, I might do a little more work on that. And then Wednesday, I'm thinking that's when the alpha update will be released. Yep, so next Wednesday, that's when you all got to look forward to playing the new version of Songbringer. Okay, so what's wrong with this door? Why isn't it? Okay. What's its condition? Item switch 1-4. Oh. Dud, condition's an item type. Oh. Okay. So anyways, if this is key, we need to call constants. That constants is key for door.condition. That's easier anyways. Making it with a friend? Cool. Ah. All right. Good. Good, Pedro. It's good to know right now whether you're going to work alone or in a team. You know, if you're going to do a game each month this whole year, then yeah, I think you're in a great, you got a great strategy here of testing out your teammate first. Is switch. There we go. Stayed off. Yeah, cool. You played it. Nice. Well, I really hope you like the new version then. The new alpha is going to be even better. As you've seen me developing a lot of the new alpha stuff. All right, great. Yeah, so it would have blocked the doors here, but it didn't. So now that bug is fixed. Yo, Zyanger, what's up? Okay, so we're ready to check this in, I believe. Get statue. Mighty Nest. Yes, mini TIE fighter. You saw that video, right, Mighty Nest? The Button Masher Bros calling it the mini TIE fighter? You probably did. The theme this month is hobby. Cool. Yeah. All right. Your game about finishing the thesis. I love that. Yeah. He's got a mustache right now. Jib. Yeah, of course. Sadoff. Yeah, Sadoff, you should post a link to your tick source as well. Because we're all talking about what games we're working on right now. Okay, there. We got a smarter door locking. TM, what's up? Nice pizza. Okay, so let's go back to this one room that I really like to check out. Locking doors. Cool, Pedro. Nice. Good start. Who's doing the art? Sweet, you got a walking animation and correct collision. Cool. Yeah. Awesome. Okay, the next thing on my list is to make an animation for the doors when they lock and then when they unlock. So let's see that again when this whole room is locked and when versus unlocked. Oh, it's from an art bundle. Oh, good way to start, man. I agree with that strategy. There we go. So that was before. Let's see one more time. I wasn't paying enough attention. This is why we need an animation, a cool animation. So you're kind of like, you notice that things have changed. So I'm just pressing the 2 key here. I'm killing all the enemies on the screen at once. And watch the doors, especially the door in the top, but also the doors on the sides. They're right the way they are now. They're locked. If I kill all the enemies, they start glowing. Even the lights next to them start glowing. Alright, so let's do this. Let's do something to make this more awesome. Flying console controllers. Alright. Oh, totally. This is my inspiration for the day. I woke up this morning and went and looked at Megasphere. Just to remember how awesome Anton Kadin's art is in this. I love the way he does this animation. But anyway, this was kind of my inspiration this morning. I'm not really going to do an animation like this, but this was kind of what inspired me. It's like running in super slow-mo or something because of Photoshop. But you can see it, like this door like flickers on its lights. These little screws twist. The doors open up and they got this cool light that appears, more lights. Man, I'm so inspired by this guy's art. He's so good. Okay, so close this one. What I want to open is the doors. Level door locked, actually. Okay, actually, I'm gonna take level door and get rid of it. So I'm gonna move everything into one. Nice, TM. Kind of Minecrafty, cool. It's called Tavern. Building Survival Business Sim. Well, cool, what's the business part? Doing it in WebGL. Sweet. Nice. Oh, sweet gifts. Oh, and your lighting too. Yeah. Yeah, Boogie. Sweet, dude. I love your art, man. Yeah. Awesome. You're starting with some great habits here too. You got your buttons already drawn, all your text, your letters, your font. Cool pixely background. Nice job, Boogie. Red Sands, what's up, man? Yeah. Oh, the business part is running an inn. Cool. John Cena. Yes. I know who John Cena is. I haven't seen the Vines, but I'll check him out. He'll probably mod you. All right. Okay, so yeah, I want these to be all right. Oh, actually I do need these old ones. So this one is door south 0. Let's put this in this one. So I'm organizing these files to make it easier to animate. Pafu. He just wanted to let everybody know he's there. All right, this is locked. This is unlocked. This is the old one. Don't need this hue saturation layer. This is just kind of play around with. Suppose you can stay on though. All right, there. Now we got a more accurate version of this file ready to go for. The one problem is this shadow. Yeah, maybe the shadow should be baked in. Or just like that. That's fine. There we go. Okay, so now we got a nice shadow for that one. Turn both these off. We got this nice, brighter, unlocked layer. John Cena. Oh, he really is injured. Dang. Harvest Moon, totally. Azenris, what's up, man? Ah. What's up, dude? Okay, we'll get we don't need this S0 anymore. Close that. We can rework this North 0. Let's go to North 0. Cool. Source games. unlocked, old. We got north, 0 for the regular door. Duplicate this shadow, make it nice for this one. This one is locked. Wait a minute. Oh, it's like a pixel taller? What? What's up? Why is this one bigger? Whoa. I don't know how this one got turned crazy like this. Shadows in Monogame, cool. Just text shadows or like shadows or entities and stuff? You bought a toaster 2 weeks ago and haven't used it once? Oh, that's maybe it. Oh yeah, this one has a pixel below it. Okay, so it is just too tall. That's better. Except for that in the back. Okay, this color right here. Oh, one more pixel. There we go. Nice. Text shadows. Oh, right. Outline strokes. Cool. Agreed. Practice is that important for sure. Okay, so this one's good. We can get rid of this. We don't need north 0 anymore. Close this one too. Okay, now we got, let's do north 1. Yeah, definitely, Pedro. I heard there were some people chatting in the stream quite a while back. This was months and months ago. But they were chatting about 2D, pixel perfect, and Unity and how to get it to do that. So there you can get it to do it. I know that, but it is tricky. So thanks for encouraging everyone to check it out. Yeah, Tom, that's a good solution. Simple, very simple. Always a beautiful thing with programming and games and all that, simplicity. North 1. This one also is too tall. Oops, looks like I needed to just shift it down like that. Nice. We're all good here. This one's locked. This one's unlocked. Shadow, shadow. This one's the old. Right. Okay. Okay. This one? Yeah, blue red one here. Yeah. North one done. Lock north one done. South zero. That one's good. South one. For pixel perfect in the browser, I'm drawing all the UI to a buffer, then scaling. Good move. That's essentially what I'm doing too with Songbringer to keep it all pixel perfect. I mean, even though I'm using two-dimensional graphics that are all pretty close to, they're all basically the same pixel size. It's just that when the shadows render, with the way the OpenGL does its stuff, I have to use a frame buffer so that the shadows get rendered all perfectly as well. Locked, old, unlocked. Looks good. Yeah, cool. Okay, we don't need that one. Now we're down to just east. Nice. Is the frame buffer still experimental in 3.9? I don't know. I haven't upgraded yet. It's a good question. I don't know. I guess I would guess that it would still be experimental until 4.0, maybe? I don't know. It's kind of difficult to know what they're going to do. All right, there we go. We got these done. This one here. This is zero is the bottom. Okay, zero is the bottom. One is the top. Zero is the bottom. One's the top. This is zero. Oops. Zero. Unlocked. No, locked. This is one locked. Actually, let's call that locked zero. Locked one. This is old zero. Old one. What's up, Protito? Oh, they do have a roadmap on Trello. Oh, that's cool. It's good to know they have that. Then we got unlocked zero, unlocked one. Da 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 da. Okay. So now that all those files are all merged and stuff, we can git move them. Double door locked east. Move that to level. What happened to the other? Oh, I already moved them. It's just level door. So I get rid of this locked. Oh, thanks for looking that up, Pedro. CC frame buffer is still. Yeah, it's still namespace experimental. Two bright pixels on east. Let's see. Two bright pixels. Where? What part of this? Are you talking about these two on the top here? If you're talking about these two pixels here, yes, those are totally intentional. They're actually transparent. Usually see through, so you can see. It looks a little bit gnarly. Like this is a little bit like got a chink in it or some kind of crack or something. Taking away programmer freedom, huh? All right, let's make sure these files are all in order. I just renamed East to get rid of all these locked, basically. Cool. Really, that's not going to affect any of the ping files. Okay. So, get these reopened. A lot more simple. I love it. Okay, I'm going to start with north, 0, and 1. Actually, we'll start with north, 1. Oh, there's one more thing I want to do to this. Actually, I want to change it so this is an animation. That's right. Yeah, so create video timeline on all these. 0.5. 0.1 seconds. We start with locked. We'll animate it unlocking. So I suppose, it'd be nice to just make these groups. Actually, no, I got a better idea. Make the same shadow. This will really help out some continuity. Okay, so since this thing is kind of indented, yeah, it's not bad. All right. So we need an animation that goes from this to that. For now, I'm just going to use a simple fade. Oh, Oculus, huh? I saw some cool Oculus games at the Indie Cup. There we go. All right, we got a nice animation between these two frames. Let's export this. Actually, we need to delete the existing level door unlocked graphics. Actually, delete all these graphics. Rich people like Wizard Boo. No, yeah, I'm not gonna purchase one of those just yet. I definitely do not have that kind of spare cash. I'm living on very, very, very frugal amounts of money per month. You know, like I could maybe afford $100 of miscellaneous expenses per month. That's like going out to dinner and all those fun stuffs that most people do all the time. I can do that like once a month. So yeah, I would have to save up for like 6 months to buy an Oculus, and that's just not gonna happen. All right, so level, maybe that's another reason why I love old school games so much. Don't need Oculus or any other stuff. New fandangled stuff. Render. Okay, let's make sure that came out right. We got north 1-0. Yeah, got a nice little fade in going on there. Dang, 750 euro, including shipping and tax. Woo! Looking forward to do any campaigns for your game? Yeah, like the one I've been doing the whole time since I ever started. Yeah, no, really, I'm already in campaign mode. I've been in campaign mode for this game since the beginning. I guess Kickstarter was kind of a special campaign. That was a campaign, and today, you know, today's development is more of just an easy sort of like cruising style campaign mode. But yeah, I've always been marketing my game and always will continue to do that. That's kind of nice with the more shadow. Okay, create a video timeline. 0.1 seconds, turn off propagate frame one and all this. Google Cardboard Edition. Wait, what's Google Cardboard? What's that again? Get it, fold it, and look inside to enter the world of cardboard. It's a VR experience starting with a simple viewer anyone can build or buy. Cool. Yeah, this is what I gotta do. Google Cardboard it. I can afford that. In case I grow another 16 pairs of eyes. Oh, wait, we had 9 DK2s. Yeah. Yeah, you put your phone inside. Yeah, no, yeah, Tom, totally. That's what I'm working on, right? All I'm doing right now is setting up the animation. I'm doing a real cheesy just fade from one to the other. I could do that easily with code. I'm just setting it up with a specific animation sequence here and getting all the files in order first so that I can do a cool animation. What I'm imagining is this little thing in the middle here will twist and like do some kind of cool animation, and the actual lines here of energy will all sort of like power up and sort of be moving towards the center. Actually, the lines will come in first. The lines will go like pew, pew, like shooting energy into the middle, and then this thing in the center will like rotate. Oh, really? Cardboard kind of sucks. Oh, yeah. Oh, I see. That looks good. Oh yeah, propagate frame one. Turn it off. Looks good. Okay. So set up this animation. You're 80. You're 60. You're 40. You're 20. You are zero. Zero, my friend. Zero. Okay, now this one's ready to render. Get these files all set up, level, render. All right, good, we got north zero. Okay, north is done, south. Wait a second, that's blue. Whoa, how did it turn blue? What the heck? Sample all layers. Oh, there, it's not blue anymore. Wow, that was weird. Oh, there's a tiny bit of blue on top here. Wow. It's really hard to see, but there's like a bluish tint at the top of this door. Yeah. Aren't we supposed to have like 3D TVs where you don't even need glasses soon? Layer, you're 80, 60, 40, 20, 0. All right, another one down, a little lower south, 0. Cool, we got south outputted. All right, now the next south. Oh no, I definitely hate 3D movies too. Oh my god, I hate them so bad. So my girl and I, we went to this, we saw Pirates of the Caribbean in 3D, and we realized we never ever wanted to see another movie in 3D again. Yeah, we felt like we were sold some timeshares. We came out of there, we're like, what just happened? This one and timeline. Right, yeah. Could you fake some bloom? What's a bloom again? I forget how the bloom effect goes. I mean, I know there's a shader for that too. It's a bloom shader. Let's look at a bloom shader. Is it just blur? Is that what it is? What's bloom? Bloom shader effect. How does this work again? Oh, the light on the bright background bleeds on the darker areas. Oh yeah, no, I can do this with just adding in some glow. Yeah, bloom is a great, oh, I love bloom. Yeah, this oh man, this is a really great technique for creating realistic lighting. I love bloom. So yeah, what I'll do to implement bloom is on like these lighter door or these lit up doors right here, I'll add some glow. Yeah. Right? Most 3D movies aren't even filmed in 3D, right? Yeah. So I'm not totally against it forever, but like at this point. Oh wait, you know, it's the ones I saw with glasses. I'd be willing to see a 3D movie if I didn't have to wear glasses. That's my problem. I just hate wearing the glasses, and I feel like it messes with my vision too. So one of these days, I'm sure they'll have 3D movies that I'll be into seeing. Eighty, sixty, forty, 20.0. Oh, so that was south 0. I think east is the only one left. Oh, and these should totally be saved. Saved as, this should be east 0, east 1. Level, we're in sprites, right? Yeah, level east 0. East 1. And we can get rid of raw sprites level door east PSD. Okay, so now we've got 1 and 2 in separate files. I mean 0 and 1. Yeah, no way around the glasses, but I thought there wasn't going to be a way. I thought they were working on stuff right now where you wouldn't need glasses to at least see 3D television. But I heard they haven't figured it out yet, but I'm pretty sure, I don't know, maybe I'm wrong about that. What's up, Salad Dongs? What's up, man? How you doing? Yeah, right, the normal 3DS. Nice, man, cool. So this one is 0. This one is 1. All right, we'll start with 1. What's this black layer? What is this for? I don't think that's needed. Wait. Is this 1? Oh yeah, this is 1. Let's take away all these zeros. We don't need those either. Okay, frame 2, 80, 60, 40, 20, 0. Render. East 1 looks good. We'll go East 0 and we'll be done. Just close one eye. What, in Portugal it only costs $5 for popcorn? Oh yeah. Dude, popcorn is so expensive. Same thing if you go to like our ball game, any kind of ball game, right? Like a basketball, football, whatever. You try and buy popcorn or like peanuts even, or hot dogs. It's all so overpriced. Just because they can. They got you there and they could trap you. It's a racket. All right. We got locked. Frame 2, 80%. 60, 40, 20, and 0. All right. All right, once it's done repacking, I just gotta go change the frames. So door component gets sprite prefix. You bring food from home? Nice. You always put glasses over your glasses? Dang, that's well, does that work? To put your own glasses over their glasses? It probably does, right? Okay, here. There's only two places where this is called. So these are the only two places we need to edit, but also this function. So we start with level door. Oh, we never use the locked anymore. And then the two places where it's called. Ah, okay, here we go. If it's locked. Oh, let's get max too. So that's going to be auto max equals. Oh, there's over yours. Right. Glassception. 3 pounds for a small sharing bag of sweets. What? Is there beer? No, most cinemas do not have beer in the States, but there are some like sort of like mom and pop style, like smaller theaters that do offer beer and food and other cool stuff. And actually those theaters don't charge as much for all the crap too. They're actually really cool. We have one here in Oakland that's so awesome. It's like a, it's not really a cabaret, but it's almost kind of like that, where you're getting a movie and food at the same time. Okay, this is going to be kit. Count sprite frames. There we go. Kit string with format. We take the prefix. We add in the %%D, and we add in ping. And that's it. That's the max. This is the max frame. Or number frames. Okay, so if we're doing, if it's locked, we use the zero frame. If it's not locked, we use number of frames minus one. Oh, wait, first we need a zero in here. There we go. It's going to be the same thing here, but we'll just one. I guess one works. Yeah, we can do one, zero. Locked, yes. Okay, there. That's all we need to do for that one. Door component, not that one. Door system. Yeah, here we go. Door system. This is percent D as well. Right? You gotta adapt if you can't drink in public, right? Can you stand the awful movies then? Yeah, totally. We have weird minor. Our minor laws are crazy here in the States too. It's like you're a minor till you're 21, which I know it's way better in Europe. I think it's. I think it. The extending the age that you like, the later you have your drinking age, the more you have these youngins that go around and drink too much. You know what I mean? Because it's not as taboo in Europe to drink beer, you don't have as many problems with it, because it's taboo here in the States, kids rebel, and that's why they do silly stuff with drinking here in the States, I think. Yeah, 16 in Germany, right? And pretty much the rest of the world, it's way more like that than here. I don't know, is there a country that has a higher drinking age than the United States? Right, the forbidden fruit is the sweetest, exactly. So that's the prefix. We need to get the number of frames as well. Oh, wait. Didn't even pass in the prefix there. That was almost a crash. All right, and here we got to pass in another one. This is if we're locked. Zero, otherwise number of frames minus one, comma. Okay, if this is all working, if this is all good, then we should have the same exact stuff going on with the doors. Nothing will have changed. Yeah, same in Portugal. Whoa, the drinking age used to vary? I never knew that. Ah, I never knew that, Saladongs. Whoa. The Vatican, right? Vatican. It's weird in the States. We have all these different laws for different states. It's almost like each state is its own little country, But it's just like we can travel from each country really easily. What happened here? Frame must be wrong. Level door north 50. Oh, that's what we want. Oh yeah, this goes after the frame. And that, I might have messed up that other one too. So we got zero. Oh, and no, I did that one right. Cool. Heard in France, prior to the reaching the age of majority, children drinking alcohol is left with the parents. Ah. Yeah, it's alcohol is never the mysterious thing to them, right? Yeah. Right. Well, it worked. Oh, that didn't work. We got a problem there. Looks like it might have just done one pixel too. Think it might just need to be one more pixel down. Right, yeah, driving age should be more. Drinking age should be less. Okay, Okay, so there's one slight problem with these new doors, and that's just that the east door, the top one is a little off. How tall is this? 84. It's 84, and to get to there, got 57. So at the top, the very, very top of this one is 27 pixels. So let's look at East 1. Also 84. Also 27. What the heck happened here? Yeah, because you gotta get a job, right? In Rome, people should not drive at all. Your driving age is 17. What if that was two? We're here, one and two. Oh, that's interesting. So your rule is that your max speed is just lower, huh? Interesting. That's a good way to do it. Oops, we broke one of the doors up there. Let's see if we fix this door though. Oh, no, damn, what happened? And you have to be male. Whoa. Wait a second. Is that right? I think it might be have these backwards. Oh, that would make total sense. Oh yeah, I think they are backwards. Oh, totally. They're backwards, that's all. Wait a second, so East 0, is the bottom, East 1, is the top. How did that get backwards? Did I mess it up here? Left bottom door is 0. Oh, yeah, I figured. You want it to be illegal for cats to drive cars? Wait, why is this messed up? We got 0 for left bottom. So 0, left bottom. I don't know. I don't know how these got messed up. Let's try swapping them. See if it just fixes it magically. This one's 1. Just call it 0. Or render to 0. Here's 0. We'll render this one as 1. Hopefully it fixes the problem. Look at the orgasm. Toons is the driving cat. I love seeing him play the bongos. What? It's broken again. Oh man. I got these totally messed up somehow. So this one is East 0. Let's save it as 0 again. Pizza, see you, man. Oh god, I've really got to pay attention to that one. That looks funny. Tootsies! Maybe it's just the west door versus the east door. Ah, you know what? I probably need to see the old frames. Ah, this is east and west. All right. Nano, what's up, man? Welcome to this. Welcome to the stream. This game's called Songbringers, like Zelda 1, but it's procedurally generated. So there's a hell of a lot more to this game than what you're seeing me do right now. But what I'm working on right now is cooler doors. These doors are gonna animate when they unlock. So like this is what they look like when the doors are unlocked. Here's sort of like the beginning of a level. There's a lot more to this game. There's like an overworld as well as levels, 9 levels per world and all that. Let's go back there. 2-2-1. Faced with difficult decision. Level design, floor tiles, all right. Whether to move, rotate each tile slightly by hand to give them a misaligned look, or if I just write a script that does it automatically. Why don't you put it in your code? Why don't you just in your code go and offset your each tile a little bit? Thanks, Nano. Appreciate it, man. Yep, so it's coming out in 2016. That's this year. Hey, it's coming out this year. The beta is right now, it's alpha. You can actually play the alpha version if you pre-order it and stuff like that. It's at songbreaker.com/pre-order. Then the beta is going to be coming out pretty soon, early in 2016, and then the final version will come out a few months after that. Okay, I'm confused why this isn't working, but it's okay. Let me git checkout raw sheets level door east 0. And east 1. These aren't being used anymore, but that's all right because I just want to see what the heck is the difference. So here's east 0. Wait, this one's E00. This is the new outputted one. Here's E0. What's the difference? 1684 is exactly the same, right? Yeah, these are exactly the same. What the hell? East 1. East 1. Oh. Yeah. Make it work, Boogie. Whoa, he's got so many commands now. Yeah. The press kit? Let me give you the press kit link. It's wizardfoo.com/press. I'll post that in the chat. Okay, are these different? These could be different. These are actually different. That would explain what's going on. We got 1684. Same thing here, right? This is 27 tall. Now we got east 1. Oh, that's door light. I need door east 1. There we go. Oh, yeah, that's the problem. East 1 is crazy different. It's chopped. So that's 16 by 57. Ah. Yes. We can fix this now. Okay, this would be 57 pixels tall. Go image, crop, and re-export. Wait, first of all, let's get rid of these two. We don't need anymore. Render. Yeah. No, thank you, man. Bakfu is the coolest. Yeah. That work? Yes, it worked. Oh, we have a working system. I just noticed that the doors hide themselves. You go from area to area, but oh well. Okay, finally we have the foundation for what I wanted to do today. I just want to animate these doors, make them cool when they open, when they unlock and lock. So now we're finally ready to check all this in. We got a good base for the task ahead of us. Level door. Doop, doop, doop. Dot ping. Cool. The cat is cool. Since we're on the subject of cats today, we'll add these two. All right. Okay, the only difference is we changed what frame is loaded based on the last frame of an animation. Other than that, it's all good. So, what should I call this? Prepping for animated door lock unlock. Prep work, get pish, get push. Right. Okay, now we can animate. Time to crack out the art pen. We don't need that. North, we'll start with north one. All right, so let's do this animation. Probably gonna need more than like 5 or 6 frames or whatever we have so far. Oh, actually, let's do the code really quick for animating when they lock and unlock. So we can see it in action, area creation. It's just gonna be here in door system. So we set the frame color. Actually, we're not gonna set the frame anymore. We're just gonna animate. Animate and color. Live Studios, what's up, man? They'll never be cat cool. you gotta sleep. Yeah. Yeah, Tom. I know it's late for y'all. Yeah, you'll see it though. I'm sure you'll see it on whatever, Twitter. I'll post it on Twitter tonight. This video will be on YouTube later. So yeah, good night, man. Have a good one. Yeah, let's see this. I just want to see this animated. I think the best way to do this is actually create a profile for each. Nice, you're almost done with the mural? Sweet. Here's the format for the animation. String format. Is that right? Why does this not have a percent D right there? Seems wrong. Yeah, that's wrong. Oh, that's just because we're getting the number of frames from that. So, yeah, this is actually door distance, blah, blah, blah. Let's call this int kind or type. Door kind, I guess, is really more of a word here. Doors, yeah, doors, keycards, yeah, the keycards are now single use, so that's awesome. That's all done, the code's done for opening doors a single time. Once you have a single card, you can use it only once, and that has created so much choice. I really would like to play the game today, but I'm not sure if I'll get to it today because I got to do this animation next, but maybe tomorrow I'll play through the game, and I've already played through one level. So much more fun to have keys that are single use because you can shortcut dungeons like crazy good. If you're a speedrunner, it's way better for speedrunners. If you're a normal player, it's way better for you as well because you have more choice, you have more power, you get to choose where you're going to use your keys. So, does Rock have to go into a lava room for the door key to change shape to fit in the door? Is that a reference to like Metroid or something? The door key to change shape to fit in the door. He should just use the card to jimmy the lock. It doesn't matter. Yeah. MGS reference? MGS? Oh, Metal Gear Solid. Okay. I want this thing to animate its current animation, which is just a cheesy fade. But that's okay. Int kind is... Oh, yeah. Zero is either the left, bottom, one equals right, top. Format, pass in kind. Oh, and prefixes first. Number frames is based on format. The frame, we can use the format. Don't need a prefix. We just want to pass in the number of the frame, which is that. Actually, no, we don't need this anymore because we're going to do an animation. So, auto ref nim. Oh, it was a stupid puzzle. Oh, which Metal Gear Solid was that? Jules, see ya. Good night, man. Have a good one. If locked, we want to reverse this animation. How do I reverse animations again? Oh, you know what? I can just do a reverse. Got the color, got the render, set sprite frames. It's actually going to be auto action equals animate, create. Nm, if locked, reverse. Actually, why didn't that work? There we go, reverse, sweet. And then render.sprite.runAction. Action. Oh, we don't need none frames anymore because we're doing the animation. Much better. Okay. Hopefully that works. We'll get some animated doors as they lock and unlock. It looks like it did do the animation, but it did the opposite of what it's supposed to do. If not locked, I guess. Action reverse. Oh, it was the first Metal Gear Solid? No, that didn't work. I want to fight. Yeah, okay, the animation ran right when everybody died, but I guess it didn't start right. So let's see if this runs at the very beginning. Jib, right? Get it when he gets hit? Oh, this does run at the very beginning. So locked, what's that going to be? Locked is going to be come true. And it starts. The door should start with not locked. DC is so ambitious. I can't wait to give him a tiny weapon, some kind of little like stun gun or something, or ray, or sword. And also to make him playable. That's going to be super cool. Finally make a two-player. Okay, so for some reason it's not starting with the right animation. Wait a second. Yeah, like R2-D2, right. I'm totally thinking, yeah, Jib is totally inspired by R2-D2. BB-8, same kind of thing, but R2-D2, classic, right? Okay, number one starts with off, and it goes to be on. Zero, same thing, off to on. Okay, so is this... As this becomes locked... So the regular action is for when you go from unlocked to, no, it was the regular action is when you go from locked to unlocked. Right. So if you're setting it to be unlocked, you want to run the regular animation. If you're setting it to be locked, you want to reverse. Yeah, so that's why that is right. But why is it... Huh, this is confusing. The tiny spark, right? One pixel? Will you have puzzles for Jib, or is he passive in single player mode? In single player mode, if there ever is a puzzle specifically for Jib, you will actually play as Jib. So in single player mode, if it's ever so important, then yes, you'll actually play as Jib. So the controls for player one will switch over to Jib. And I'm thinking that would be like a whole dungeon for Jib. There might be. I'm not promising anything yet, but the idea is maybe there's one dungeon where you play as Jib. Rock, paper, scissors. Oh, no. What's going on? Why isn't this working? So this should be off. Okay. So obviously this is hitting this breakpoint at the very beginning, which means it's the door starts at... Actually, I want to see the breakpoint before I even modify lock. The stream would be full of 12-year-olds. It's probably going to be like that when it gets close to release time, and especially after release time, yeah. Do I follow Ditto? Who's Ditto? Sorry? Ditto on... And on what social network are you talking about? So I feel like I should know who Ditto is, huh? Okay, so we're trying to set lock to be true, and it should be starting with unlocked. Right. This is the north door. Good. Ditto. Well, cool. Goner game, huh? Cool. That's awesome. You're 12? It doesn't. You're a cool 12-year-old, though. I think what he was talking about was the 12-year-olds that just try and troll and stuff. You know who else is a 12-year-old? Rocket Bunny and Scottish Pizza just turned from 12. So there's lots of you cool 12-year-olds. You guys are awesome. Your trigger's the word trigger. I'm triggered. Ditto mad. You weren't being serious? See, that's why you're so cool, man. That's why you belong here. Cool. I'll check out this guy's stream later. Stream of tweets. Yeah, Rocket Bunny is almost 13. Scottish Pizza's a zombie. Really? I thought we were having this conversation the other day, and I thought he was 16 too, but like, I think you said the other day he's turning 13. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it was somebody else. Okay, so logic here. What's wrong with this? It's the door starts. We're setting it to be lock true. The door starts is lock false. It has to. And that means that when we get down to here, the format for this animation, level door north 0%. Yeah. Who had the birthday? That was Scottish Pizza. Maybe he doesn't know. Happens. That does happen, right? Age means nothing to him. Age. Age of Bafu. So this should be running the animation. It's currently the door dot locked is now true. So this door is now locked, which means it needs to play the unlocked down to the locked animation, which is the reverse of the animation. Okay, so maybe I just had this wrong the whole time. Yeah, I'm 36. I'm 36 now. I just finally turned 36. You thought I was 30? Thanks. Nah, see, this didn't work. Neither of these work. There's gotta be something else modifying these frames or something. Or maybe there's two actions. Let's try deleting whatever. Render.sprite. Stop all actions. If it's not locked. When is my birthday? December. December 11. Yep. I just turned 36. Okay, how about this? How about we just only animate an opening for the moment? Door.locked. No, if not door.locked. All right, Lime, see you, man. I thought I did. Oh, you know what? It's because, you know where I was on the 11th? I was not actually streaming because that was the same day as Indy Cup. Yeah. Or no, was it the next day? Oh, no, it was the next day. Sorry. I went to Indy Cup on the 10th or something like that. And then the 11th of my birthday or something like that, I had to go see my family that weekend. My aunt passed away, so it was kind of a, downer birthday. But yeah, I wasn't streaming. I was doing that weekend thing. That's why. Did that work? It should start as locked. Oh. Oh, they're not even starting right. Okay, let's turn this off completely for a moment. I'm excused? All right. Yeah, it's okay. She's in a better place. She's in a lot of pain. She had cancer. There we go. Okay, so at least it's applying the right frame for that. It's just it's starting with the wrong frame. So locked. Oh, and that is of course because. This. We need to do the number of frames and all that. So if not door.locked, we'll do this animation. Else, if it is locked, we'll just set the frame. There, I think that'll work. All right, see you, Zanger. Ooh, so much math and code today to get all this work. Yay, there, finally. Finally. And then if I kill everybody, it animates it opening. All right, that's all I wanted to see. Great. Now I can do the animation. Yay. Okay, finally, art pen time. This is so fulfilling. This is so fulfilling to do single-use keys. I thought this wasn't possible for so long. I thought this would be so much more difficult than it was. But it really wasn't that difficult to implement this. And thanks to Azimris for the great suggestion yesterday of making it so. Basically, there's certain parts of the maze that can get locked. You can skip parts of the maze now. Like, for example, here in this first dungeon, you could grab the first key and actually open up the second door and skip this whole section down here in the bottom left behind the first door. But let's say that this were a dungeon where there was an important item in here that you need to get in order to traverse something else. The solution that Azimris came up with was, he's like, why don't you just make it so when you defeat the boss, it opens up all the unlocked doors, or all the locked doors in the rest of the dungeon. So I love that solution. That's really simple. So whenever you beat a boss, it's just going to open up the past doors. So you're not locked in the game. Like, you're not going to be lost. Like, if you really did, you know, because you can always complete a level. This is always possible to complete a level. It's just the fact that you might skip certain sections. So if you do happen to skip a section and it did have an item, then it will open up when you get to the boss. So The game will always be completable that way. So, let's do some cool animations for this now. Going from locked to unlocked. In fact, yeah, you will still have an extra key, but that key will always be within that section where you would have had to use the door anyways. And I can make it so when you actually kill the boss, the key that you would have found is gone, right? It's just used up somehow. So if there was like this, key number two, this item would actually just be used up as if you'd already found it. So I think it'll all work out. And I think it'll be kind of a rare case that you would that a player would skip a section and then want to even go back, because the game is pretty smart about putting the most critical items closer to the end of the level or even in the goal room. So I think it'll all work out. Yeah, because it's behind a locked door. Exactly. Right. So look at this. Every section has a key. And it's behind a locked door. I may change that in the future. I may make it so that you can actually put keys either in the current section or in the zero section, because that also will work. But you couldn't do one section, two section, three section, because that might create a skippable path that would break the dungeon. So for now, it's just putting always the first key is within the first section, the next key is within the next section, the next key is within the next section. But it's still interesting to play because you still have that choice as a player. It's kind of like the old system of using color-coded doors. It's just better because you can choose to skip sections or you're not even aware that you're skipping sections anymore. It's just that you really have a lot more choice. Really, the only way that you would know you're skipping a section is if you already had a map of that area or you just knew it really well, like you're speedrunning. Okay, so I want this to be an animation. All right, so the first thing is to take this glow, which is, let's delete all these frames. Put this glow on top. Hold on, do I got flux on? Is it dark out? Oh, it's dark out. Turn flux off. We gotta disable this until sunrise. Whoops. For current app? No, until sunrise. Oh, let's turn this one off. All right. So everything that's white, do an inverse there, delete it. Yeah, we have exactly the same frame. So now I've got these white things as a separate layer. Now I want to animate them moving in and this thing rotating and stuff. Actually, the first thing I want to do is animate this thing popping out and then rotating. All right, so let's do, I'll separate these. Okay, that's going to be a separate layer. So it can move and rotate and stuff. And all right, set off. See you, man. All right, this thing's ready to rotate now. First, I want it to pop in and out. So I guess it will start like that. So this needs to be underneath. It's going to start one frame up. Yeah, it's going to go pop out. You got to make the sound effects. It's so important. All right, if it's like that, we need this. We need, this thing's going to have. Oh, this needs to be a layer below everything else. How many frames was the other ones? How many pixels? We got one. Oh, there. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. These are darker too. Yeah, way darker. Okay, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. There we go. Okay, yeah, totally. This thing can go. Wait. Moving the wrong shit. Here we go. Okay. Boom. Oh, that didn't work. Okay, so this, the bottom part of this half of this door needs to be all one frame. Put that below, merge that with this one. Now this thing's gonna be sandwiched between the two. So yeah, no matter what, I can go up or down. Yeah, sweet. Okay, now I need to see a couple more frames of this thing rotating. I think I'm gonna do 45 degree rotations here so that it looks really, really fast. Like it'll look like it's rotating really fast. So we'll call this one 0. This one will be 45. Oh, I messed up. It looked good there for a second. Now it doesn't. If it spins fast enough, you might not be able to tell it messed up. I'm hoping. I'm crossing my fingers that that is the case. That's usually how pixel art works. Even a tenth of a second is really hard to notice. Actually, a tenth of a second is noticeable if you're an animator or an artist, really. But like, or you're just, you know, sensitive to that or whatever. But like, once you get down to a 20th of a second or even a 30th of a second, then it gets really hard to tell. So I might do this one at a 20th. I usually do a 10th. Maybe I'll do a 20th for this animation. I'm trying to think of a way that I can actually clean these pixels up a little bit without messing it up too. But actually, let's just do that like this. How did he get a pixel all the way down there? Oh no. Oh, there we go. This is easier now. Yeah, I can obviously see what's wrong here. US don't have a specific unit for angle degrees. We don't? Isn't it degrees? It's, from now on, degrees will be known as scribberties. I love it. I love that name. All right, this totally looks like Dookie. It just needs to be moved up one pixel, I think. It kind of looks horrible, but oh well. This needs to all be connected there. There's only degrees and radians. So what do you guys use? Do you have an official? Yeah, 45 degrees more or less. 116,000 scribberties? I love it. Scribberties for the win. Yeah, okay, so there should be those connected too. That there. This here. That there. Oh, degrees is used everywhere, but not radians. So you guys don't even use radians at all? What about math? What about programming? Okay, good enough. That's the 45 degree one, which is great because now that we have the 45 degree one done, all the rest are going to be easy because zero is the same thing as 90, basically. Rotate 90 degrees clockwise. Yep. 90 is the same thing as 135. And 135 is the same thing. Wait, it's 180? Yeah, we need 180. And that's it. Well, I guess there's a 272, right? Wait a minute. No, oh yeah, 270 is the same thing. I didn't need that one. Is that right? Did I miss something here? Yeah, it was 90. Okay, right. There's 0, 90, 1. Oh, okay. Oh, no, not 135. This is wrong. This one's 180. No wonder I messed up on my counting here. There, we got 0, 90, 180, 270, and then back to 0. So let's see this thing. We got enough to now almost animate it. Yeah, I think we do. There's enough to animate this. So let's say this guy is like that. It's like sunken in a little bit when it starts. Okay, there's frame one. Let's do 20th of a second for this animation here. Frame two goes down three, down another one, four pops back to normal. Oh, wait. Sorry, I was messed up. This is supposed to start with upside down. Yeah, so this is, let's keep that normal, but let's do completely upside down 180. Oh, and one pixel in like that. Yeah. Let's make this thing look mechanical. Actually, I think this might need. You still don't get Photoshop's animation? What are you having trouble with? What part? Maybe I can help. This one's gonna be 180 U, kind of like it's the upper frame. And 180 not U is like that. So I can shave off a few pixels on top here. I think that's gonna help the animation fit nicely into the other frame. Okay. Let's turn off propagate frame one. How did it get turned on? I'll never know. Why can't you select multiple layers and turn it off at once? You can't. All right, there. That's frame one. Frame two, we switch to the 180 in its normal position. Frame three, the 180 comes down. Oh, you just never used it? Yeah, it is convoluted, that's for sure. DM John, what's up, man? You want to make an ancient temple floor tile? It's kind of in similar style to yours. Any tips? Did I use any references? No, I didn't. I don't know. I just kind of came up with drawing little runes and stuff. That's all. Yeah. High five, man. I don't know. I guess my recommendation would be to go and try and find a reference, try and find something that inspires you, and or maybe this does inspire you, but just take it and create whatever kind of your own art is. Use references, right? Every artist uses references. And that's something I realized as an artist, right? Sometimes as a programmer, I thought, oh, as an artist, you have to have all your own completely original ideas, but that's complete BS. All artists use references, especially when they're starting out drawing something or sketching things. So, yeah. So just, use references, but make your art your own. That's my only recommendation. Find a way to make your art your own. But look at things, look at other people's art, and use it as inspiration. You're just balls at art. You can get better. Did you see the From Programmer to Artist series I did? If you want to check it out, it's just look for Google, look for From Programmer to Artist, Wizard Foo, and you'll find my little tutorial on how to become an artist from being a programmer before that. All right, now it's going to start rotating. 180, 270. 0. Yeah, definitely. You saw a couple of those? Awesome. Yeah, definitely recommend watching Speed Art. Totally. Yeah, I'm glad you saw them. Cool. Oh, it's Code to Art. Sweet. Yeah. Boogie. Bob Fu. You guys are the best. So this one's 0. This one's going to be 90. We'll go back to 180, 270, and ending it off at 0. And then I guess we could do like a sort of like, let's do a totally lit up version. Whoops. Okay, here's the lit up version. I'm just going to duplicate this layer 4 times to do a 20th of a two-tenths of a second. You're also trying to figure out random dungeon generation. There's no programming in CF2.5. What's CF again? So it seems harder than just writing code to do it in Java or C. Oh, so you can't code. CF, what's CF again? Creative... Cold Fusion? All right, let's see how this animation looks. I do plan on doing some cool animation for the light turning on, but for now it just flickers. Oh, Click Team Fusion. Oh, okay. Oh, never heard of that. But that's the... Oh, it's the next version of Multimedia Fusion. Okay. That's kind of cool. See that loop forever. Okay, it's starting to look good. Yeah, you remember Click Team? Wow, cool. All right, so there's something here where these look really weird. Oh, maybe it's that one. Doop, doop. Oh, yeah, that totally is a bad one right there. And this one has a bad frame too. Two D game dev? Ah, it's similar to Construct 2. Ah, so you can't do any coding whatsoever? Okay, so 180 needs a pixel off right there and there. Actually, it needs to move down one. And then remove that pixel, that pixel. Visual coding, yeah. Uses its own logical modifiers for type of visual coding, but mostly just makes loops. Oh, Ah. There we go. So that looks a lot better. It's just flipping the bottom part of it now. When any you There we go. So that should be up one pixel there. All right. Yeah. Overcaster, what's up, man? Yo, howdy. 2 hours and 20 counting. Wow. Okay. Well, I'll call it quits here in just a second. Let's look at this animation once it's all cleaned up. And yeah, that'll be it for today's stream. No idea how to predefine rooms and generate an entrance and exit, ensure a path link, right? All right, Overcaster, cool man, you too. So I need to clean up frame, the 90 degree frame too. Right. Oh, textual format. Good thoughts, Salad Dongs. All right, there we go. We got 90 fixed. 90's looking good. 180's looking good. 180U is looking good. 270 needs some help. It just needs to go down one pixel. Yeah. Oh, wait, wait. 90 needs all these pixels. Ooh, 180 is good. 180U needs some pixels too. Inertia is a hell of a drug. What's up, D-Dan? I'm working on an animation for doors locking and unlocking. Let me show you in the game what this is finally going to look like. Here's the doors that are unlocked. These are locked doors. Up there, see that red door? It's locked. I'm going to kill all the enemies using a cheat, and it'll unlock the door. So there, it's unlocked. But now I'm working on an animation for making it look cool as it unlocks. So it's got this little piece that goes in and out, and I'm just touching up the bits of this animation each frame. Looks like I kind of messed this one up here. So that needs that frame. That there. Dedan! Can I call you Dedan? Is it Dedan or is it Dan? Or is it Dan? Is it Daniel or Danielle? Sorry, I don't want to assume. I always have a hard time pronouncing people's names, so I always ask. Okay, whatever. All right, cool, man. We call you Dedan then. Okay, now 180U. One more frame up, and then delete these top pixels. Yeah, that was a tricky one. It took a while. Okay, I think the last one is 270 now. Just gotta remember to do these pixels here. What's up, Panaliti? Yo, how's it going? I'm almost done with the stream here. I'm just working on this little animation. See if I can get at least one of these exported before stream is all said and done. This is going to take a while to do all these doors with this new locking animation, but it's going to be it's totally worth it. It's going to look sweet. Okay, I think it's finally the last frame we need to worry about. All right, so this is going to be 180U. That's it for the frame one. Okay, let's see this animation. Oh, it messed up. Looks like 180 changed. Two seventy's got a problem there. Looks like 90 also was too high. This 180, all these got messed up. Okay, now it should be ready to watch. Back into game dev after a 2-week break. Awesome, man. Okay, it didn't pop out. It's supposed to pop like there. Wait. Yeah. There. Here's the pop layer. So this one goes down another one. Okay, let's see that again. Yeah, there. It's supposed to pop. Okay, I'm gonna see what that looks like in the game. And then that's it for today's stream. So level door N1. Ooh, there's gonna be a crazy problem. I think I can hack around it though. Let's render that. Why didn't it ask me to overwrite? Because it kept all the old frames. Yeah, good night. I'm gonna run it until I get this actually running in the game. But yeah, it's just about finished with the stream tonight. So here we go. Level one, let's delete all of these. And then let's create this hack in here. Actually, no, let's not do the hack. Let's do a better way. 02D. And what's the other one? Door system area creation. Percent. This is going to be 0, 0, 0. And then this, all these frames are going to change. Because it has more frames now. Man, there's a lot of work to get this all going, but most of it was prep work. Stuff like this. Almost there. All right. So now I just gotta wait for just to repack his texture one more. I see. Let's just do remove it. Assets, textures, level. Because that would be common. All right, let's hope that works. So all I want to do is see it before I shut the stream down, but I might have broken the game. Who knows? We'll see. So this is going to look weird too, because one door will have a nice animation, one door will not have it. Oh, looks like it did break it. Damn. Oh well. I'll get this fixed. I'll show it off tomorrow's stream. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. Thank you all for watching. Thanks all for your continued support. I appreciate it. This game's called Songbringer, if you didn't know, and it's coming out this year. And I'll be back streaming tomorrow. So see y'all. Have a great night. Have a great day. Cheers. Yes, rip the door.